Hello everyone. This video is about the introduction to document object model. So in short, we call it as DOM. So the purpose of the understanding about the DOM is to make sure that the various elements and objects of your web page can be accessed and can be managed for your web applications according to their requirements. So basically, whenever you write a web page, which consists of your HTML code and along with the CSS tags and the corresponding selectors, what happens is the browser builds up a particular model. In short, it is a data structure. So that data structure is nothing but basically a document structure based on the elements that you have been using in the web page. So let us consider one example here. It consists of HTML code. Of course, the first statement indicates that this particular HTML code is following the HTML5 version. So exclamation mark document type is HTML indicates that you are going to write a code which is based on the HTML5. So starting with your HTML tag, followed by your head section, and then the body section. So if you look to the hierarchical structure of this web page, so you have the starting at the higher level, we call it as an HTML tag. So under the HTML tag, you have two different categories of tags. One is on the head section and the other is on the body section. So this we can see in a diagrammatic representation, that is a pictorial representation of your web page. So inner HTML, the inner, what you see it on the diagram is where the HTML is on the inner side. It's like a basically a container. This container is holding two different sections. One is your head section and another major section is the body section. So what is present in the head section? So in the head section, in this example, we have just a title with some text. So that's what you see it inside the head section. Again, you have another tag, that is the title tag, that is your another object, which is this object contains a text value, which is my home page. And when you come to body section, the body section tag, that is basically it is itself an object. It contains several other elements. So what you see in this example, you have an H1, the heading section 1, which contains a text, my home page, followed by a paragraph P, and again and one more paragraph P. This paragraph again contains some other elements such as a hyper reference, that is using the anchor tag, along with that some text, and then followed by your dot. So you have three elements in this paragraph tag. That's a paragraph element. In other terms, the paragraph object. So you can call it as an element, you can call it as an object, you can call it as a component. So all remains the same in our web terminology. So you can see this every web page that you write with the help of tags, this basically objects or your elements or your components, is being structured in a proper way. And whenever a browser sees this set of tags, it builds up this document structure to understand in a proper way so that you can manage this web page for your application purpose. So you can, when you say manage, means you can access as well as you can change the values of different objects in the interactive way. When the user is interacting itself, you can, based on the user actions, you can, the corresponding objects gets updated, the corresponding values gets changed here. So that is the advantage of having the structure, the document structure, in a particular hierarchical manner. So this data structure makes the browser to represent the documents that follows that particular shape. So each box that you see here is basically an object which we can interact with to find out the things that are present in your HTML page. So a tag it represents, and a boxes which the text it contains. So this representation is basically, we term it as a document object model. In short, we call it as DOM. So if you look to the DOM tree, that is a hierarchical structure of your web page. So your web page, the root object is basically your HTML, that itself is your document object. So under this document object, you have two categorical or your major objects. That is, one is for the head, another is for your body. And the head tags contains other sub objects such as called as title and the corresponding values here. So here you can see the body tag which contains the heading tag followed by two paragraph tags and the corresponding text here, which is representing the corresponding values of the particular web page tags. So this basically represents a parent-child relationship. So you can access the elements of this web page. Those elements, you call it as an objects, and you can try to change their corresponding properties, as well as you can change those functionalities by using certain methods. So the World Wide Web Consortium termed this document object model is a platform and a language neutral interface that allows programs and scripts to dynamically access and update the content structure and the style of the document. So as you're seeing, you can make the changes to your existing contents based on the user interactivity. You can as well as restructure those elements and the style of the documents using your CSS. So here, let us start with understanding about the HTML DOM, which is a standard for how do you get the elements into your program, and how do you change, or you can add new objects, or you can delete the existing objects based on your application requirements. So some of the basic methods that you try to use it in understanding this DOM concept is basically something called get element by ID, get elements by tag name, get elements by class name, get the elements for various CSS selectors, get the elements which are being defined by various other HTML elements, so on and so forth. So let us see how these methods can be used in your programs to manage various objects, as various elements of your web page. So let us see with one by one example. So let us start with a simple basic example, get element by ID. So whenever we design our web page, so the elements of the web page can be accessed with the corresponding ID that you might have understood in our HTML basic course. So here, the ID each itself is been the attribute which conveys that this is an identifier, and you are giving an identifier such as para 1. So this is P is the your original element, that is what your tag, the paragraph tag, and the paragraph tag has got the attribute ID, which designates that this particular thing with a unique name. So these ID numbers can be unique, and which represents certain kind of representation of your tag elements that you have been using in the web page. So para 1 is the identifier or the ID which you are given here in this example. Now, once you are, how do you access this particular paragraph tag? You can access the paragraph tag by using that particular name at a different place of your web page. So you might have written so many, write so many other tags here. But in this example, just to understand the basic purpose of get element by ID method, so I've written just only one particular statement with the paragraph. But in the real scenario, you will see that your HTML page contains so many tags and so many other elements. So at the time, to access a particular value at a particular position, you may this get element by ID is going to be at most useful for us. So you are accessing this get element by ID, that is the ID which you are given here is para 1, with the help of your document object, which is referring to the current web document. So document.getElementById, the method is accessing the ID. So here the by ID itself implies that you're trying to access this particular paragraph tag P, which has been designated by para 1. And you're trying to put some value, that is I am from get element, whatever the text you like to have it. So this is another inner HTML is basically setting the property to that particular paragraph tag of whenever you are accessing to this. So get element by ID is a method, and inner HTML is the property that you are going to use it to define access that particular tag and to ascertain certain values into this. So let us see how this particular program gets us. So let me just copy this one. Go to the Notepad editor, open a new file. Let me edit this code properly. Right, save this file, save as into a particular folder where you're keeping all your source codes. So example 7, which is basically related to DOM. And this is the file extension is
HTML. This is basically an HTML file. Save this, right. Now once you have saved this, let us see how this runs this particular program. Select the file, open with the browser, Chrome. Right, you can see this now. I am from get element. That's what the paragraph, the way the text has been seen. We need to understand the elements properly in the hierarchical structure. So let us take the first example itself to understand the DOM structure. So I'm taking this first example once again. Control C, go to the new file. Right, the new file, you just edit the code. It looks fine. Then save this particular file and give a name to this file, example 8, which is related to dom.html. Save the file in the same directory. Fine. So basically, this is the HTML5 version. So open, go to the file, open with a browser. Right, this is the, once you open in the browser, now you can see various elements on this one. So let us go to the developer tools. From more tools, you can get the developer tools. Now you can see the elements here carefully. Let me put this video aside. Right, so now you can see this. See what you are seeing is the head tag. That is what you are getting the title, which you have been defined here under the title. So that's all that you can see. My home page, that you see it on your web page, my home page, then followed by the body. So this is what the body section contains, the entire body. Inside the body, if you are looking for a specific element, yes, you can type it here. That is what your heading section, H1. And this is what is the another element, that is what your the another object, that is a paragraph 1, and followed by another paragraph. This is a paragraph 2, which contains the hyperlink along with the dot here. So these are the various elements, the DOM structure, which you can see it clearly on your web page. So the body section, once again, I'm repeating, this is the body section. The entire body section contains various other elements. This is what your heading 1, which you kept it in the body section, followed by paragraph P1 and another paragraph P2, which contains the hyperlinks, and which you can click here the links and you can see the corresponding pages which are running for you. So this is how your DOM objects are being structured in a hierarchical manner. That is, that we call it as a DOM tree. So let us go with the other set of methods that are available with the DOM. So we have seen get element by ID. Now let us see get elements by tag name. So the tag name itself is sufficient to access the corresponding elements if you are located at a different place in your program, and you can ascertain the particular corresponding values. So instead of get element by ID, you can use the tag name. The tag name will be referring to the corresponding element that you are going to access here. So copy the code, go to the new file. Yes, now. Right, save this particular file, save as. Example 9 is related to dom.html. Save it. Right, let me just check if everything is okay with respect to the indentation and the quotes. Right, para 2. So here, para 2. Yes, now it looks fine. So let me just save it. Then let us open the file in the browser. Example 9. So now you can see here, this is a para 1, which has been indexed onto your another paragraph. Thus, you are accessing with your tag name itself. So this is how you are going to run it with your tag names. Now let us see one more example. There is another method called as class name. So get elements by class. So you can see you are specifying a attribute called class. So what is the difference between an ID attribute or a class attribute? That's basically, these are selectors. You are selecting a particular tag name. So ID and class are going to be used called as selectors to select one of those elements of your web page. You can call it as selectors or you can call it as a tag here, more or less the same in this context. So ID can be used to identify one element, whereas a class can be used to identify more than one. So here you can see the class name is C1. Similarly, another class is also there, means another paragraph is also being defined with C1. So if you have multiple identifier, means multiple tags are there, if you want to classify it into one class, you can give the same name and you can access the corresponding elements. There is a difference between an ID and a class. Let us see how this particular program runs. Select this one, the program, go to the new file. Right, let me save this file now. This is your 10th program. Let me see, the program is correct syntactically and semantically. This looks fine. So let me just save this. Save as example 10, which is related to dom.html. Once you save this file, you can open the file from the folder, the example 10, open with Google Chrome. So the file is opened here. You can see the class name. So you can see that you are getting that particular corresponding text. The DOM is very useful in this particular paragraph 2, which you accessed by the class name C1. So the DOM will help for us to access the elements at different locations, where you can put some images, where you can access certain values. So in the real time, when the users interacts, you can take the value from a particular text box and you can place it onto another variable and use it for our data processing at the client side itself. So that is the advantages of the DOM. So the reference material is from this particular textbook, and this book is available on our university library website, Eloquent JavaScript. From this, I have referred to the DOM concepts. The DOM concepts are available here. The same diagram, the same text is there. So please do refer to this particular information. The introduction is enough here. So at least this particular set of information that is going to be useful for you to design and develop your web pages efficiently. Yeah, thank you.